Lynn, you'll have to go. I can't get away.
Neither can I.
But you'll be back in a week if you catch the 4:30 plane today. Why can't you?
David's decided to leave me.
David's done what?
He's left me.
Well, that's ridiculous. Well, you and David...
Oh, I know. That's what I thought, too.
Well, when was this?
Yesterday afternoon, in the middle of a cocktail party. Sent for his things this morning.
But why?
Harry, I don't know why. I'm sorry. He just didn't know it was loaded, I guess. He wanted me to go to New Bedford with him. He's got a job there.
New Bedford? You couldn't do that.
Well, maybe I could. If it were only a question of going there. David came in and handed me my marching orders and expected me to follow right after him.
Well, it'll probably all blow over. I remember my first marriage. We were separated a dozen times before we finally made it stick.
Made what stick?
The separation. He's probably only bluffing. Wants to put his foot down on something. The thing for you to do is to outbluff him.
Thank you, but I'm not interested in playing games.
Your bags are here, Miss Claymore.
My bags?
Yes, I had them call your home and pack a few things for you. Get my coat and hat, Mary.
Yes, sir.
Did you tell them to be sure and put in my new printed silk? Harry, I'm not going to the coast.
It might be just the thing for you to do. Make David come to his senses.
Evidently, that's what he's trying to make me do. His lawyer phoned this morning in case I want to make arrangements.
Lawyer talk, eh? Then everything's going to be all right. Sam Walker's waiting down in the car right now. He'll take care of everything for you.
What is he, a mind reader? What made him think I'd need a lawyer?
Well, as a matter of fact, I got him over here to talk to you about the Gordon contract, just in case you did go to Hollywood.
You know I'm not going.
Sure, sure, but look how it works out. There isn't a smarter lawyer in the country than Sam. So if we just all ride over to the airport together, you'll have a chance to talk it over with him.
And what happens when we get to the airport?
Well, if you feel you ought not to go, I'll take the plane.
With my bags, I suppose.
I had them put a bag in for me, too. Come on, Lynn.
You know darn well you didn't have your bag in the car.
But, Lynn, you decided yourself you ought to go for your own good.
Oh, I suppose so.
Don't let them kid you about that Gordon contract. Studio hasn't a chance in court and they know it.
And don't forget what Sam said. Don't tell them you talked to a lawyer. Just play dumb. But sweet.
I know.
Say, by the way, have you and your husband any joint bank accounts?
We've never had anything but a joint account.
And you call yourself a businessman. I'll close that out tomorrow.
Look, I'm getting awfully sick of you two boys. Can't you just run along?
Oh, now, Lynn, we're only trying...
I know, you're trying to help. But you remind me of a couple of vultures.
At a time like this, what you need is vultures.
Couldn't find a better vulture than Sam.
Harry, you will telephone me, won't you?
Oh, naturally, every day.
I mean, if David changes his mind. If I've outbluffed him.
Oh, sure.
Flight 9, Nashville, Dallas, Tucson, Los Angeles...
Well, here I go. Goodbye, Harry.
Goodbye.
So long,
Sam. Goodbye, Lynn. Don't worry. I'll take care of everything here.
Miss Claymore?
No, Mrs. Connor. Oh, yes, Miss Claymore.
Hey, Lynn! Wait.